the vitamin tree or the miracle tree. I mean, the leaves of this tree are loaded with antioxidants, anti-inflammatory compounds, claiming to help treat anemia, skin diseases, infections, respiratory illnesses, high blood pressure, diabetes, and cancer. But is moringa really worth all of the hype? In this video, I'm going to be going over the scientific literature. I'll also be taking a special look into four of the top health conditions moringa is famous for helping treat, including obesity, diabetes, high cholesterol, and menopausal symptoms, and giving you my professional opinion on whether or not I think moringa is helpful, harmful, or just a plain hoax. What's up, super foodies? Welcome to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Tessa. I'm a licensed and practicing pharmacist, as well as a NASM certified personal trainer and nutrition coach. And my goal with this platform, as well as my online services, is to help educate people around evidence-based natural therapies in order to help you improve your overall health and well-being and be your best version of yourself every single day. Now, it is important to remember that natural remedies and certain foods can interact with disease states and medications, so make sure you're talking with your personal doctor and pharmacist before supplementing with anything. So first off, let's look into moringa's nutritional value. If you go to the USDA nutrition database and enter 1 tablespoon of moringa with the amount that you might get in a smoothie, 1 serving of moringa powder has as much vitamin A as 1/4 of 1 baby carrot, as much vitamin C as 1/100th of an orange. Put that in perspective, an orange has as much vitamin C as 100 tablespoons of moringa, the calcium of 1/2 cup of milk, the potassium of 1/4 of 1 banana, the iron of 1/4 cup of spinach. So yeah, it's nutritious, but it's not off the charts like everyone is making it seem. I mean, to be honest, it's really not more nutritious than fruits and vegetables. So what about moringa's safety as a supplement? Moringa is likely safe when consumed in food amounts, long-term, and in medical amounts in about a 6-month period of time. Now, it is important to note that moringa root and root extracts are different than the typical moringa powders you might see on the market. Make sure to avoid eating any moringa root or root extract, as they have been seen to cause nerve paralysis in animal studies. I would also strongly recommend to just kind of avoid moringa in general if you are pregnant, breastfeeding, because traditionally moringa root bark and gum from moringa has shown to cause miscarriages, and the effects and safety of moringa have not really been evaluated in breastfeeding infants. In addition, there was a man who developed Steven Johnson syndrome following moringa leaf consumption. It's a really rare but potentially fatal condition. So this is why moringa is not really advised for those at a higher risk for Steven Johnson syndrome. Once again, this is a very rare side effect. We only saw one case study of it, so a lot of things could be playing into it. Certain medications can increase your risk for Steven Johnson syndrome, so just be aware of that. And though you can buy it as a powder, pill, oil, or tea, supplements and powders made from moringa aren't regulated by the FDA, like most other supplements. That means there isn't a standard dose that you should be taking for health benefits, and companies don't have to prove that their product is safe or that it works as advertised. If you want to learn more about how unregulated the supplement industry really is and how you can spot safe and pure supplements, go ahead and check out the video below linked in my description. So for a typical healthy individual, no medications, it seems likely to be safe. But what about moringa's effectiveness in helping treat and reverse certain health conditions? Does it have some magical properties to help with these conditions despite the lower nutritional value? The first condition I'm going to dive into is obesity. One small clinical study shows that taking a combination product containing moringa leaf extract daily for 2 months does not reduce body weight when compared to those not taking the supplement. In fact, patients in the non-supplement group showed slightly greater weight loss than the patients in the moringa group. Next up is diabetes. Animal research shows that moringa leaf can lower blood glucose levels, and moringa's effect on diabetes seems to be the most promising. For example, if you have people eat about 5 cookies, you obviously have some sort of blood sugar spike in your system. However, if you add just 2 teaspoons of moringa leaf powder into the cookie batter, even with the same amount of sugar and carbs, the blood sugar spike is diminished. Also, people who drank 1 to 2 cups of moringa leaf tea before a sugar challenge suppressed the elevation in blood sugar in all cases compared to those just drinking water instead. But does it actually work in people with diagnosed diabetes? Diabetics were given about a 3/4 teaspoon of moringa leaf powder every day for 12 weeks, and they did get significant improvements in the measures of inflammation as well as long-term blood sugar control. The problem I have with this study is that there was no control group. Since there was a lot of room for error within the scientific method, having a control group present is vital for accurate analysis of these results. The researchers just took measurements before and after the 12 weeks, so we can't be certain it was the moringa itself that had the potential benefit. Even in a moringa study with a control group, the researchers didn't specify how much moringa people were actually given, and the study saw no significant improvement. There was one study that showed eating a meal containing 50 grams of moringa leaves reduces post-glucose meals by 7% in patients with type 2 diabetes not on a hypoglycemic agent compared to a standard meal without the supplement. Another study, once again of low quality, showed that powdered moringa leaves, 8 grams a day for 40 days, reduces fasting and post-meal glucose, total cholesterol, and triglycerides in patients with type 2 diabetes on hypoglycemic medications. However, there's other research showing that taking tablets containing powdered dry moringa leaves for 90 days along with a hypoglycemic agent does not improve A1C compared to the treating with that one agent alone, with a few studies showing potentials, but a majority failing to show any benefit at all. Don't think I would necessarily add it to your regimen, because there is much better scientifically supported superfoods and supplements that do show a benefit in those with type 2 diabetes. What about those with high cholesterol? Well, long story short, all the studies showed to have little or no clinically significant benefit. Once again, there's much better scientifically supported superfoods to help those with high cholesterol. Finally, what about menopausal symptoms? Clinical research shows that taking fresh moringa leaves 7 grams with food daily for 3 months modestly improves symptoms such as hot flashes and sleep problems in healthy postmenopausal women compared to those who weren't taking the supplement. I also have a video of my classification of maca powder, another commonly used superfood for menopausal symptoms. The link for the video is below in my description. So with all of today's scientific research, safety data, and nutritional value being taken into account, right now, I'm classifying moringa to be a hoax. I was so excited to learn more about moringa, and I can honestly say that I'm sad I didn't find more positive aspects to moringa. The lack of scientific evidence moringa's benefits just isn't enough to justify the high cost of the supplement, especially when you can get the same or even better nutritional values by eating regular fruits and vegetables. But the one thing that I love about science is that it is ever evolving and changing, and who knows, maybe in a couple years this video will be completely out of date and I'll be one of moringa's biggest fans, but as of right now, it's a no from me. If you want to learn about supplements and superfoods that do have a clinically and proven benefit that could help you and your health, I do offer supplement consulting services. We're based on your lab work, diet, lifestyle, medical conditions, personal symptoms, exercise habits, and health goals. We create a personalized herbal, nutritional, and lifestyle protocol for you in order to support your optimal health. If you're interested in a free wellness consultation, click the link below in my description to book it. I am also taking on clients for my Remedy Wellness Experience, which encompasses personal training, nutrition coaching, supplement consulting, and medication education for a 12-week total lifestyle revamp program. This experience helps identify and addresses root causes of medical conditions and diseases, illnesses, and other complications. This integrative experience focuses on improving the 6 key areas of wellness to ensure you're living your best and your healthiest life. So you can also use that same link for that free wellness consultation for the Remedy Wellness Experience program. Now, if you want more day-to-day health superfood tips and tricks, follow me on Instagram at the Superfood Pharmacist. And if you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and hit that little bell notification so you're notified each and every time I upload a new video. If you have any questions whatsoever, make sure to put them in the comments. Also, check out my video description for all the scientific literature and references that I use down below in my description. Thank you again so much for watching this video. I hope you found it helpful, and I'll see you next time. Bye.